And going down this weekend, we got a Super Bowl rematch. The Niners face the undefeated Chiefs. The Niners are even at 3-3 as injuries have really played a factor early on in the season, including star running back, of course, Christian McCaffrey going down on the IR in week one. Now, Patrick Mahomes, though, and the Chiefs are unbeaten, as I said, but Brock Purdy has more touchdown passes and fewer interceptions than the Chiefs quarterback. Still, Mahomes is the plus 325 favorite to win his third MVP, while Purdy is just 13-1. Now, look, I mean, we don't need to call him Mr. Irrelevant anymore because now he's more than relevant, but we obviously know the difference between Purdy and Patrick Mahomes. Yet still, I have to ask the question, would you rather have Brock Purdy or Patrick Mahomes, Stephen A.?
Well, of course, it's going to be Mahomes. I mean, I'd take Mahomes over anybody. But I will say this. Let's give some love to Purdy. He played well enough in the Super Bowl. He wasn't the reason they lost. You know, he showed up, and he's made a name for himself, and he deserves a lot of credit. It's just that Patrick Mahomes is one of one. You know, he's not somebody that, you know, when you look at the way Purdy has been playing this year, so far Purdy has played better.
Correct.
But that doesn't mean he is better. And so we have to recognize that and give appreciation and respect where it's due, but understand this is the true testament to greatness. When you're as great as Patrick Mahomes, it really doesn't matter how average you look from time to time. Because we know when it really, really counts,
yeah,
your greatness will show up.
Yeah.
Because that's what you repeatedly do. And so that's what makes him stand out above that. We don't know that about Purdy yet. We know that about Patrick Mahomes.
I feel we know that about Brock, but not in the way that we know that about, or to the level that we know that about Patrick.
I'm talking levels.
Right, yeah.
I'm talking levels.
It's Patrick. I want Patrick versus everybody on the planet.
Of course you do. There's no disrespect to Brock Purdy. I mean, Brock Purdy is a very good quarterback. Patrick Mahomes is a magical quarterback.
Patrick Mahomes is in the conversation for the greatest quarterback ever.
Of all time.
I will tell you this, though. Had Brock Purdy closed the deal and they were able to beat Kansas City,
even though you still would be
Mahomes, it would be a stronger argument in favor of Purdy to that degree. Not against Patrick Mahomes, but you'd look at him and go like this. This brother is special, too.
He's special, but I think we can agree, not in the way Mahomes is. Why would anyone pick Brock Purdy over Patrick Mahomes in this game? Maybe Mina Kimes is going to join us. Maybe she has a different opinion on this. Hello, Mina. Would you rather have Brock Purdy or Patrick Mahomes this weekend in this game?
Yeah, in this game is the key phrase here. I want to be very clear. I am not taking Brock Purdy over Patrick Mahomes over the course of a season, over the course of a career. Mahomes is the best quarterback in the NFL for me. But in this game, I am going with Purdy here, starting with the fact that this season, so far, Brock Purdy, 5th in QBR, Patrick Mahomes, 16th. Brock Purdy, second league-wide in completion percentage over expected. Patrick Mahomes, 23rd. Brock Purdy leads the league in average depth of target. Mahomes, dead last. It is undeniable that he has been the more productive and effective quarterback. Now, context matters a great deal for that. While there have been injuries with the San Francisco 49ers, a Chiefs fan would look at their complement of weapons and say, I'll take any of them, and they will be almost fully loaded this week. Last week, what we saw from the Chiefs offense, they looked very good, but I find it unlikely that we're going to get a second Juju Smith-Schuster game the way we did against New Orleans. I feel like this Chiefs offense still needs to add a pass catcher for me to have confidence in the passing attack. I think Mahomes is going to be significantly challenged because of that. So I'm going to bet on Purdy, continuing what we have seen from him this year. And what we have seen from him this year, and Dan, I've said this, is the best football of his entire career.
Yeah. No, I agree. I think Purdy's been better this year. I completely agree that this is his best season going. I'm still taking Patrick.
Even with six picks.
Yeah, I'm still taking Patrick in this game. Yes. Now, I do agree what we saw from the Chiefs' offense after we saw the Bucs hang a 50-burger on the Saints. I think it was a little bit more the Saints' defense playing poorly and blowing coverages and running into each other consistently that helped some of that Chiefs' offensive performance, specifically to a Juju in their pass game. But I do know this. Chiefs have the better defense than the 49ers. And I think clearly the better defense than the 49ers. I think number one, the Chiefs still are one of the, if not the best teams in football offensively, yards after the catch. It has become an identity of theirs ever since Patrick's really taken over as quarterback. and it's starting to show itself a little bit more this season. I don't know if by desire or necessity, but the yards after the catch, huge. San Francisco still, as a defense, struggles stopping and defending teams that primarily utilize that. They've been bad at this year defensively. So while I understand the point that Purdy's played better than Patrick and whatnot, I still think in this game that I do like the matchup for Patrick and that offense, mainly because of that. I think we see a lot of the catch it, spit it out, get the ball in space, yards after the catch, force San Francisco to rally, kind of like what they've done, you know, for the couple times that they've played over the past couple years.
I got to tell you this, though. I think we need to pay attention to San Francisco's defense in terms of the pressure they're capable of applying, because Patrick Mahomes has been sacked 9 times this year. Mm-hmm. And when you look at that, that's the most he's had through the first 5 games in the season in his career. So we got to pay attention to that. And if you can apply pressure to him, that might disrupt some of the things that Kansas City wants to do. I don't think that it will happen. I think they'll be, Andy Reid and them boys will be prepared for it. But nevertheless, San Francisco being who they are and how badly they want to beat Kansas City, I mean, that stings. 2 Super Bowl losses in the last 4 or 5 years to this same franchise, knowing that you're going for a Super Bowl, this is probably the last hurrah, knowing that the likelihood is that they'll be the one standing in your way. You had them in the Super Bowl and you gave it away, double-digit leads in both Super Bowls,
sure,
and lost both. I think those kind of nuggets of information contribute to that adrenaline rush that can get you out there and make you go after. I think it's something that we can't ignore.
I really hope Niners fans are watching, by the way, because sometimes they accuse me of bias on account of my Seattle leanings. Brock Purdy played really well in the Super Bowl. We're talking about these quarterbacks. He is not the reason why they lost that game. I just want to make that point. To Dan, your point about the yards after the catch, completely true with this Chiefs offense. However, a big part of the reason why they do lead in those categories, or they're leading in some of them, is because Rashee Rice was still in this offense when they were building up those numbers. My hesitation here is the likelihood, because you need someone other than Travis Kelce to produce. Do you believe that Juju can do it again? Because you alluded to the Saints' busted coverages. One of those big catch and runs was off of busted coverage. I like Juju as a player, but the number one receiver in this offense, like, you feeling good about that?
No, I still remain adamant that I expect them to add a piece. I don't know if it's going to be Hop. I don't know if it's going to be Christian Kirk. I don't know if they try to trade for somebody else. I've been constant that if they are going to three-peat, they have to add another wide receiver. I still think that they can play functional. Now, here's my main thing with this game. I still think they'll play functional offense. Stephen A. brings up the point of pressure. I think the main person in this game is Bosa. What do they do with Bosa? Because the Chiefs, like, you can sit there, if you're the Chiefs and you say, well, we want Bosa to be on a certain side, do you want him to be on the right side of the offense and then you constantly don't help against Bosa? Because that doesn't bode well. Or do you want him to be on the left side, which is where they've struggled, that left tackle, and you're constantly helping, you know, because you're going to have to help that tackle. When they played him during the regular season, I think it was last year or 2 years ago, MK, they just didn't block him. Like, that's all they didn't do. They just didn't block him. They jet sweeped him to death and all that stuff. So Stephen A's point, like, I think the best way for San Francisco's defense to make this Kansas City offense play poorly is Bosa's got to dominate the football game, and then the counter is going to be, how do the Chiefs handle that?
What is up with Christian McCaffrey? When is he coming back?
We don't know. He's got
no nice
idea.
To see Debo back. It's nice to see Ayuk still around.
Mason's playing well
out of the running back spot. He's not McCaffrey, but he's playing well for them. When the hell is this man coming back?
I don't know.
This is it. I think this is it.
For the 49ers?
When we could talk about the 49ers, I mean, coach, you got Kyle Shanahan, you got Lynch. They know what they're doing. We get that part. But in terms of as presently constructed, this is it for the San Francisco 49ers. You don't do this. You don't get it done this year.
I mean, you can only get so close so many times.